attention, please. Good morning. Good morning, boys and girls. Welcome to our Christmas chapel. Who's excited for Christmas? All right, I'm going to open in a word of prayer, and then we will have our Pledge of Allegiance from Mr. Auskos. So let's bow in a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this opportunity where we can gather together to celebrate you and your birth. And Lord, I just pray that you will bless this Christmas chapel and the message and all the singing and glory and praise that we will be giving to you. Lord, help us to posture our hearts to you as we start our chapel, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Please stand. Please stand. Pledge to the American flag. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands.
Pledge to the Christian flag. Ready, begin.
I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior
whose kingdom it stands.
One Savior crucified, risen and coming again.
All right, thank you. You may be seated. So I'm going to spend just a short little amount of time explaining the meaning of Christmas. I know that we are all excited and we are all thinking about the presents and the Christmas trees and the lights and the lovely red sweaters I see here and green and the bells and the candles. And there's just so much about Christmas that we love, right? Yes. I particularly love presents, right? Do you guys love presents?
Yeah.
Yes. So, I have some to show you. Look at this. Wow. Wow, look at that. Isn't that grand? And look at all these gift bags I have. Oh my goodness. All these presents. All these gifts that we get at Christmas that we receive and give. But what is the problem here? What did I just cover up? Do you know? What was I just covering up? Yes. God. Okay? A manger. There was a manger here. I just covered it up. And what did I just cover it up with? Presents, right? And we get so excited about Christmas. And we get so excited about the lights and the trees and presents. But sometimes that gets in the way of the true meaning of Christmas. What is the true meaning of Christmas? Jesus, right? Jesus' birth, not the present. Jesus coming down and being born is the greatest gift of all. And it is the true meaning of Christmas. Jesus, our Savior, being born. So I just want to remind you that presents and trees and lights and cookies and cakes and chocolates and friends and family are all wonderful. It's all part of the Christmas celebration. But don't forget that the true meaning of Christmas is what happened right here in Bethlehem in the manger when Jesus, our Savior, was born. And why is that so important? Because Jesus came to become a man so that he could save us from our sins and brokenness and so that we can have a relationship with him. And that is the greatest gift of all. And that is why we celebrate Christmas. So when you go home and you have your lovely Christmas break, remember the true meaning of Christmas is that we have received our Lord and Savior, the birth of Jesus Christ, who has come to save us all. Do you guys agree? Yes! Okay, so with that said, I hope now that we know the true meaning of Christmas and have remembered that as we celebrate and listen to each other sing, that we give praise and glory to God. So now let's welcome our Christmas program.
Christmas is a time for celebrating, a time for rejoicing, a time for
keeping promises.
Keeping promises. Not exactly where I was going with that.
But it's true. From the beginning of time, God has always kept his promises. Just look at Adam and Eve.
Who? Us?
When God made Adam and Eve, he wanted to be close to his creation forever.
Right. God made man to be close to him. But then Adam and Eve made a really bad choice. Eve made me do it.
The snake made me do it.
But you still made the choice.
Yes. True.
Touche, anonymous narrator one.
As I was saying, they made the choice to sin, and it broke the relationship between God and man forever.
But God had a plan to keep his promise and bring us back together again.
That sounds like good news to me.
Me too. What was the plan?
Great setup, Eve. But do you think we'd really give away the ending before we do any singing?
For real, we set this whole thing up and all these people are watching.
Exactly. Christmas is a time to remember all the great things God has done. There's no better time than Christmas to sing about it. God really has done great things. In fact, he's given us everything we need.
But in the Bible, God's people sometimes thought they knew the best.
Never heard that one before.
They stopped trusting God and took matters into their own hands.
Like in 1 Samuel 9, when the Israelites decided they wanted a king instead of relying on God to lead them. They chose a man named...
Saul's the name, and you're welcome. Always wanted to see my name in lights. Israelites, that is.
Saul was a handsome young man who stood head and shoulders above the rest.
It's all right, man. Mom struggles with dandruff, too.
Well, I never.
But Saul turned out to be a bad choice, so God appointed David as king.
Hello.
David was a great king who loved God, but even David didn't lead perfectly.
Israel wanted a king, but we were still missing something. The king we needed couldn't come from earth like me. He had to come from heaven. And years later, on a quiet night in my hometown, God provided the true king we needed.
suddenly was with the angels a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying,
"Thanks, anonymous narrator too, but we'll take it from here."
So there we were, ready to explode with excitement. The Son of God was about to be born.
And those poor shepherds, they had no idea what was about to happen. We didn't mean to sneak up on them like that, but if angels suddenly appeared to you, how would you react?
But it sure was beautiful. All of heaven was rejoicing because the promised king had arrived.
Remember what we sang?
I remember like it was yesterday.
The song we had been singing for hundreds of years had finally welcomed this baby to the world.
A baby like no other.
When the angels went away into heaven, the shepherds said to one another,
"Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made us to know."
When they arrived, they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger.
The shepherd told of the news from the angels. Then they returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had seen and heard.
But Mary treasured all these things up, pondering them in her heart.
"Behold, the Son of God has come. His name shall be called Emmanuel, God with us."
All throughout history, God has been preparing for this moment.
When he created the world, God promised to be with us.
When we disobeyed him, God promised to redeem us.
When we were trapped by our sin, God promised to rescue us.
When we were longed for a king, God promised the King of Kings.
When we tried to go on our way, God promised the Good Shepherd.
When the world needed a miracle, God promised the Messiah.
When the world was filled with darkness, God promised the light.
And when the world needed saving, God promised a Savior.
When I think upon Christmas, I think of how God's promises have always been true, and the truth has never been clearer than the night our Savior was born.
Christmas is all about the promise of Jesus' birth, but it's so much more than just one night.
When you choose to believe the promise of Christmas, you are changed forever.
That's the cool thing about the promise of God. It's unbreakable. And once you know something, you can't unknow it.
Jesus is the promised Savior to you. Now that you know, what are you going to do about it?
Celebrate like the angels. Worship the King who always keeps his promises.
God will do great things through you at Christmas and all year long.
What an amazing morning this has been. Yes. Thank you, Jesus. And I have to say, thank you to every single one of you, because your music, your singing, your best effort this morning really just touched my heart so much. I could feel the love of God in my heart as you guys were singing, and you were singing the truth that God sent his son, Jesus, to be born on this earth because he loves us. He wants to send the light, and Jesus came to be the light to show us the way to God. So I am so moved. Y'all did such a beautiful job. Let's give God the praise this morning. Can we give him a big clap? Thank you, God. Oh, awesome. Merry, Merry Christmas. Okay, I've got one little great announcement, and that is for the next 2 weeks, you guys need to stay home and have winter break. And there's one little bonus day. After 2 weeks, that Monday in January, you also get to stay home. So don't come to school on Monday, January 3rd. Stay home. Come on Tuesday, okay? Come on Tuesday. Tell your mom and dad for sure. I promise, no teachers will be there. Okay, and let's pray together. All right. Oh God, we love you so much because you love us so much. You sent your best. You sent your son, Jesus. You gave him to us, Lord, to save us. And we just want to say thank you, Lord, for loving us, for giving us the joy to the world, the peace in our heart, the love that saves us and forgives us of all our sins. God, thank you. Thank you so much for Christmas. And thank you for these beautiful, awesome children in this room. Lord, bless them, keep them safe. over winter break. May they have a wonderful time worshiping you, enjoying Christmas together with their families. And we look forward to being together in the new year. Thank you, God. May you bless the rest of this day too. In Jesus' name, and everybody said, all right, thank you. So boys and girls up here, you may. And I'm going.